what is the purpose of design patterns? First of all, easy knowledge transfer. So you have some experts in your company who really are senior developers and know their stuff. How do you get this knowledge out of their heads and into the minds of the young people, of the junior developers, of the new members in your development team? And of course, by writing it down, and by writing it down in pattern form, this makes it easier to understand. And it makes it easier to transfer this knowledge between the experienced people to the younger ones. Also, it's efficient problem solving. You just can reuse an existing idea. You don't have to reinvent the wheel again, but just reuse what worked well in the past and know that it's useful for your purpose, for your problem. And yeah, then you have efficiently solved this problem. You don't have to come up with your own ideas. Or you don't have to reinvent existing ideas. It establishes a common vocabulary. So in your project team, all developers should speak the same language. Because if one says, I've just invented a factory and it does this and that and produces some, shoes or some other objects or some whatever, then a different programmer who comes into the team and doesn't know the word factory or understands factory as the classical design pattern, the factory method, then there could be some problems in understanding. So design patterns try to avoid these misunderstandings by establishing a common vocabulary. Everyone should know, if I use a strategy, what is meant by the design pattern strategy. And it increases the usefulness of an idea. A pattern, as I said before, is not a solution or is not a single solution. It's a more generalized form of the solution. It's the idea behind. And this idea then is much more useful than just giving a specific solution. And it can be applied to much more projects.